Better than good. Good to me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So many doors are open. So many ways to make. So many times you hear it all. You be better than good. Matthew chapter 5, verse 20, if you haven't said amen.
Amen.
Bible speaks and says, "For I say unto you, that except your righteousness it shall exceed the righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees, ye shall in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven."
Not Lord,
not
Lord.
I say unto you that except your righteousness exceeds, somebody say exceeds.
Exceeds.
Well, you know, I go to church every Sunday.
Well.
We don't just look the part. God continues to bless the friendship family in ways that I have never dreamed before, attracted before. Oh, practically and providentially, God continues to order and structure our ministry organizationally. And it's not just because we have smart and educated people at the helm. God is faithful unto us because we do our said best to be faithful unto God.
Well.
People have come to join the Friendship Missionary Baptist Church, and we have to make certain that we are good stewards thereof.
Yes.
We have a variety of teaching opportunities, a variety of opportunities by which we can study the Word of God, internalize the Word of God. But that's just the beginning of the process.
We
have to be careful that we don't become spiritual hard drives.
Not Lord.
Because the key to anything internalized is not just how and when you put it in. Key to anything internalized is what you get out of it.
All right now.
We are quick, we are swift to speak that which we don't really believe.
My Lord.
Sometimes we are quick to recite verses of scripture, and there are no evidences that we believe that which we profess. There's a great temptation. There's a great temptation in your life and mine. We really want to understand the Bible. There's a temptation, a great temptation to hear the Word of God, whether that be Sunday school, whether that be Bible enrichment, whether that be sermonic settings such as this morning. There's a great temptation to understand the Word of God, but to only be superficially satisfied with knowledge acquisition. It ladies and gentlemen, only to be satisfied with supernatural knowledge acquisition without real faith in biblical truth.
Well, my Lord, my Lord.
It is one thing to believe something. It's a horse of a different color to have faith in something. People come to church every Sunday and they believe the Bible. The Bible that they believe says faith without works is dead. So they believe the Bible and they have obtained the facts therein, but there is no manifestation of faith relative to that which they believe. Ladies and gentlemen, it's very easy to know something, but it is a totally different thing to operate in that which you know. Yes. Furthermore, to allow that which you know to operate on the inside of you. We cannot surmise, we cannot take for granted, if you will. We can't surmise that, we can't say, we can't give an attestation that we truly understand the Word of God unless by way of His Holy Spirit we have an internalization of the Word that we say we believe. Right. Ladies and gentlemen, you can read the Word.
All right.
You can hear the Word.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, but unless through the Holy Spirit you internalize and experience the Word, you have not assimilated the Word into your life. Say you believe it, you can shout amen, you can roll under the pews, you can lose your wig, you can kick off your shoes. Unless the Holy Spirit activates the Word that's on the inside of you. Not until then can you truly say you experience the Word of our God.
All right.
It is out of that experience of faith and interaction with the Holy Spirit that our words must become manifested in your life and mine.
Uh-huh.
It's easy to speak about God.
Yeah.
Do you not know that Satan himself
is very familiar
with our God?
Yeah.
You read the Bible and you like what you read in instances in which he encounters God. You know, there's some people that just know how to get your goat. And you read the Word of God, when Satan has the gumption and unmitigated gall to approach God, he knows exactly how to get at God. Ladies and gentlemen, it's easy to speak the Word of God, but the individual who truly knows God that does not just speak the truths of the Bible, not just believes the truth of the Bible, but assimilates that word into their lives.
Yeah.
Pastor, you've used the word 3 or 4 times. I did not pay attention in English. What does assimilation mean?
Come on now.
So glad you asked. Here it is. The assimilation of the truth, ladies and gentlemen. You come to Bible enrichment. You come to Sunday school. You come here every Sunday for the 10:30 worship experience. When someone assimilates the truth of God or practices what they profess, the truths contained in the Bible, that's what we call righteous living.
Well,
let me put another pen right here. You do know you can do what's right and not be righteous.
Come on now.
Let me talk to the people over here that school. You can do the right thing and not be righteous in your living at all. Do you not know that there is a difference in obedience and compliance?
Well, come on now.
I'm going to stay here till I feel better. Because I can, by way of practical position, comply with what you say and have no belief in what you say at all. Ladies and gentlemen, assimilation is when we practice what we preach, for lack of better terms, and that's called righteous living. When a person, let me give you some examples. when a person says that they read the Bible, and in that Bible it says, go ye therefore into the world and preach the gospel, it's one thing for you to recite your cute Sunday school memory verse. Now watch this. When a person reads that in the Bible and he goes to his fellow man and declares Jesus Christ unto him, that is, watch this, practicing biblical truth.
Come on now.
Now, if you say you agree with the word of God and the content therein, and that the Bible is true, and you quote that we should go ye into the world and preach the gospel, and yet you won't tell your neighbor how good God is, you are not assimilating what you profess into your life.
Come on now, preach.
Ladies and gentlemen, we can say that about everything that's printed in the Word of God from cover to cover. Jesus says unto us, if ye shall ask anything in my name, it's in John 14, read the whole chapter, you'll find it. John 14 says, if ye shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. But the question is, do we spend time incessantly, effectually, and fervently praying unto God? When all of your grammatical communication with God is interrogative in nature, that's a problem.
All right.
We talk to the people over here.
Right,
I gotta wake up in English class. An interrogative sentence, Sister John Johnson knows this, is one that asks a question. A declarative sentence says, watch this, I'm saying this, and I understand that this which I am saying is in fact.
Fix it now, make it plain.
If all of our conversations with God are interrogative in nature, that's a question. We have problems, ladies and gentlemen. Watch this. We say to ourselves, John 14 and 14, but if we ask anything, he'll do it. But do we spend time praying with God?
Well,
it's 5 days in the week that the FNBC Prayer Lifeline is alive and well,
yes,
and we can't find you on that one of
them.
Ladies and gentlemen, watch this. God.